call whatever name you want to tell me, like different people. Pastor in church, uncle in church, lesson teacher, school. But that conditioned my mindset, like she said. So for me, it was normal. You know, normally when it's time for you to probably get harassed or raped, sometimes you get to a point you shut down. Probably you're in a bus and somebody's trying to touch you. You are not, normally you're supposed to shout, right? Or scream. But someone inside of you is shut down. You are looking at the person, but you can't move. You can't say a word. And you're asking yourself if you are normal or not. You are normal. It's just normal that sometimes you shut down. Now, my case was different basically because when I got to a particular age in, I think, 25, 26, I told my mom about one of my experiences. Then I already knew what was happening. But what happened? She didn't believe me. Do I blame her? No. Because it was from a man of God. And so the moment I reported, he kept on saying, no, it's not true. She was dreaming. It's a mindset, a spiritual attack. And you can know how bad that is. When I'm telling her, no, this man did this, and she's saying, the man is saying, no, it's because I've been praying for her. So the spirit world, our spiritual world's bad. That's what my mom believed. But he believed me. So what did I do? I took the key of trust. I locked that door and I trusted it. So for every man that came my way, it was easy access. I didn't have to struggle. I stopped struggling with them. I stopped reporting. I stopped complaining. Do and walk away. But it affected me years after. It made me a calm, quiet, very good girl. Anyone thought I was quiet? I wasn't. There was no one to talk to. Maybe I'm alive today because of you. I tried committing suicide several times as a child. Several. Go to the cabinet, pack pills, you know, pills that change color. Dream them, go to bed, lie down straight, that I want to die this way. Error. I wake up the next morning healthy. Because God needed me. So many kids try the same thing again today. And I'm alive for a reason. I hated God. God was evil, he was devil. Because I felt, why didn't you fight for me? Why allow me to go through all this? Well, now I know better. It's already like this. You have the power. He might be older. She might be older. They might have more power. You know, the dynamics is there. But you know the greatest power you have is your mouth. Your mouth. Like she said, when you have a healthy mind, your mom might not believe you, will mind you. It could even be someone in the family. It could be anyone. You need to learn to speak. Look for someone you can trust. Most of you have been sexually harassed. Most of you, your parents don't even know what you're going through. Most of you have probably one time of you have tried to commit suicide. But then is it worth it? You let somebody else control you to take your own life. For the person who doesn't understand how you feel. I understand that parents are looking for money. I understand that parents might not be there most times. Mine wasn't really there. But then I had to train myself. And that's where I'm coming. You have to train yourself.
I'm sure there's no 10-year-old here. I'm sure we all know what penis is, we all know what vagina is, we know what sex is, right? So as long as you know what sex is, you are old enough to train yourself. There are children your age who don't have parents, and they do pretty well, or they're still doing well. So having parents that don't give you attention is not an excuse. I had to train myself. Today I'm a sex coach. I hate sex. It was not a problem when I got married. I used to pass out. Just my dark face. Why? Because it triggered certain things that happened to me when I was younger. And so what you do today, you might not understand. It will affect you in future. That's what I'm saying. The fact that everyone is doing it doesn't mean it's right. My reading, my learning, my wanting to know about sex made me a sex coach today. I didn't think I could read after university. I just wanted to just probably, you know, walk, not in an office. I didn't want anyone to box me up, oh, you have to sit at the table, get promotion, read, go to school, no. But today I'm doing online courses. Today I'm reading online. Nobody's begging me. I'm doing it because I want to know more. Because I want to help more people. When you know your value, you know what you're worth. And until you find yourself, you remain the same. It's enough you have issues you can't talk to anyone about. Sometimes sit yourself and write it out. Write out everything in your head. And then read it again.
Thank you very much, Soul Spice. And last but certainly not least, Omolara.